If one of us can read Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. We praise Allah and we thank Him and we send salah and salam and salutations to the noble Prophet Muhammad salawatu rabbi wa salamu alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us the ability to be in His house on this very special day, Yom Jum'ah, Friday. We bear witness there is none worthy of worship except one Allah. He is one and He has no partners, and we also bear witness that the noble messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the final prophet and slave of Allah the Almighty. Respected brothers and my dear youngsters, my young children, I would like to speak to you about something very important today, and that is answering a question, that why should I become a Muslim? What would Islam offer me? What is exclusive and unique about this religion? Because there are so many other religions available. You have mainstream religions, and you have also some ethnical religions, Christianity, Judaism, Hinduism, Buddhism. There are so many ideologies available. You have liberalism, you have secularism, you have so many different ideologies out there. But out of all of these things, why I should be Muslim? An important question. Especially youngsters, you may have some time, you may think, why should I be a Muslim? Aske ami ekta proshno uttor dilam sei ramze ami khere musliman hoitam aro to onek dhormo chola ache religion hola ache khere musliman hoye amar kitab hoye special kitab musliman hoye islam dhormo na kitab special. So let's try and answer this question in the next few minutes. Number one, I would say Muslims are fortunate and lucky to worship a being called Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At least we're not worshipping animals, cows, or statues and idols, or human beings. There are some people in this world who worship human beings like prophets, and they made them part of divinity and gods, and they worship them. There are people who worship animals and cows right in front of our eyes. Thank Allah that you don't have gumutra. You know what gumutra is? The urine of cows, the pee of cows. There are people who have it systematically and formally. Thank Allah that we don't have that. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you're not worshipping idols and statues. You go and stand there for hours and hours. Thank Allah that you don't worship while you are shaking and jumping and dancing and singing. We worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with enough serenity and tranquility and calmness, and with some inner connection and feelings, we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have somebody called Allah, and that's the best thing in Islam, and that's the best concept of God out of all religions in this world. And this is one of the reasons for why Islam is attracting a lot of people to the concept of God in Islam, which is very clear. And hence you will find a lot of Christians and Jews and people from other religions, they are unhappy with the concept of God in their religions, and when they find Islam, they find Islam to have the best concept of God, and which is the original teaching of each and every single prophet alayhi salam. Is that clear? That we have something, and we have someone called God, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, one and only. Surah Al-Ikhlas, Qul huwa Allahu Ahad, is enough to understand the theology of a Muslim, belief of a Muslim. What's the belief system in Islam? Especially about God, about Allah, Surah Al-Ikhlas. Just study and read Qul huwa Allahu Ahad, Allahu Samad, Lam Yalid wa Lam Yulad, wa Lam Yakul Lahu Kufuwan. Covers everything of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is one and only. Allah is self-sufficient. Everybody is dependent. dependent on Allah, and Allah is not dependent on anybody. Lam yalid, he never begets, and he was never begotten. He never gives birth, and he was never born. Walam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. And there is nothing in this world like unto him. There is nothing similar and resembles Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Concept of Allah is so clear in Islam, and we as Muslim, we are happy to have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we worship Allah and not like anything and everything like so many people do. Without, of course, being disrespectful, but just a comparison. Alhamdulillah, Muslims worship Allah alone. And you are happy about it, and you are 100% satisfied about this. Number two, we say we have something called hygiene in Islam that you will hardly find elsewhere. Pobitrata. And in Purishka Purichunata, Islam Dharma Demarata Girish, Unnodavata Vitale. Look, religion is teaching you to clean yourself first of 5 times a day. Wudu. And once you have some sort of activities like intimacy, relationship, you have bath. Which religion is teaching that? You clean yourself, if not 5 times, 3 to 4 times a day of wudu. A religion of cleanliness and hygiene and purity inwardly and outwardly. Not like just putting like sprays outside and looking good and internally not clean. I used to get surprised sometimes when I used to travel to Middle East and Muslim countries. As soon as you arrive in the UK, you say, you find strange, there's not anything to use the water. And about nothing. There's nothing there. So you feel strange, like you're pinched everywhere you go and there's water, but here you don't find water to clean yourself. It's not enough, like tissues, you know, it's not really enough, especially if you relieve yourself. Religion of hygiene, absolutely. People of the world didn't know. Islam offered that unity, that cleanliness and purity, not just outside, but inside as well. I was thinking, unfortunately, for some reason, they kind of gave up outside. Like, you know, comparatively. They don't care about the look anymore. They don't care about how they behave, how they sort of like present themselves. Don't forget Islam is a religion which also gives importance to your presentation. Islamically, within the religion, you don't do something against Islam and say, I look good and I look beautiful. No. Within the boundary of Islam, you present yourself beautifully. And this is the practice of Sahaba of Allah. So, wudu, if you ask, what is wudu? Have you ever thought about wudu? That within 2 minutes, you clean all the exposed part of your body. মানে শরীরের সকল খোলা জায়গা হল 2 মিনিটের ভিতরে আপনি ওজন মাঝে আপনি ক্লিন করে দিলেন এরকম আর কোনো সিস্টেম আছে নিবেন না There is no any system. Within 2 minutes, you're cleaning your face, your hands, your inside your nose, inside your mouth, like mother, you know, you do the rinsing your mouth, ear hole, খানোর ভিতর, খানোর ফিস, কোনো সাইড বাকি নেই তো। Everything you're cleaning because it's mentioned in the Quran. Quran is telling us to make wudu. And we do wudu sometimes, we don't even think what we're doing. But it's a form of purity. It also experiences sins. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, like, you know, it's like cleaning and bathing oneself from like physically. And that's how it cleans your sins as well. And your dhunub and all sort of like, you know, bad things. So wudu is something that a Muslim has. That nobody else realized. Within 2 minutes or 3 minutes, you are cleaning all exposed part of your body. And you're preparing beautifully to stand in front of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala to worship Him. Beautiful thing. After you travel, so you go out at 10 o'clock in the morning, and you have a lot of work to be done, and you do a lot of activities. By the afternoon, 1 o'clock, you make wudu, imagine how you feel. You feel good. You put water on your face, and a lot of problems go away. The stress goes away. Anger, although it helps to reduce the anger, if you have a problem with anger, make wudu. Read durood. Durood Sharif Ranjan is there at the commission. But I'm not sure I'm not going to have a problem with it. If there is a problem with anger, you can go also make wudu. Because it can extinguish the fire, the anger. Then we have another system in Islam that to answer the question again, like why should I be Muslim? We have a beautiful system of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the salah, the prayers. You cannot show me any other form of ibadah in any other religion which is as beautiful as salah, the prayer. And there are people I know that have been inspired by just looking at the Muslim how they pray. You see in London Central Mosque, which is part, a lot of non-Muslims that come every day. Visitors, approximately 60,000 visitors a year. And then all non-Muslims from all different backgrounds, starting from the government to all some organizations and people from all backgrounds, and also people from abroad, the European countries. And many of them, they say, they observe the salah of Muslims. They sit down right at the back of the mosque, and they observe the salah. And they say sometimes that this is something amazing. But you stand in front of Allah, and you read Quran. You don't understand it. You're reading the book of Allah, a message from Allah, from God Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, praising Him, making incantation, dua, Allah in Fatiha. Then you bow down. You bow down in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not in front of anybody else. Rukua. And subhanahu wa ta'ala azim. You're glorifying Allah. You're praising Allah. Then you stand up and go to sujood. 8 parts of your body are on the floor. Your forehead, your hands, your knees, your feet. 8 parts of your body on the floor, and you are glorifying and praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Humbling yourself, meaning like there is no more humbleness than state of sujood. And sijda is a binota by that. Tawazo. And take a share binota no the humbleness. Is it a strofa? And this is the reason why salah was prescribed. Alladhina hum fi salatihim khashi'un. The salah should make you khashi'. Someone who fears, someone who has khushu', someone who has devotion, someone who has also the humbleness. Then you go sujood, they were sitting down, and you think, and you see, and you are doing all these things without putting shoes on, no shoes whatsoever, and you are standing right on the floor, and you're doing a beautiful form of worship. All these things that you do, everything is makes sense and also prescribed. Has similarities in the religion of early prophets. So salah is a beautiful form of worship that you cannot find elsewhere. And this is another reason for why a lot of people, when they come to the mosque, they are easily attracted. And this is the reason why, inshallah, when the mosque of course become big and when it's facilitated, it should be open to the non-Muslims so they can come and visit as well. Because it's a good way of worship, form of da'wah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a good, beautiful thing. Sometimes they don't know what we do. And this is the reason why they get a bit like tensed, what these guys are doing inside. So if they sometimes come and see, and inshallah, hopefully this become one day much more facility and bigger place where we can have all these different facilities, inshallah, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept and bring you dua and support. Inshallah, we can do that. But as I said, you've got Allah, you've got hygiene, you've got salah, and last thing I want to mention, that no other religion gives as importance as respecting your parents and elders than Islam. Islam is very clear and stands firmly when it comes to parents. After Allah and His Messenger, Allah ibn Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Anbiya Karam Prabhade, Sahaba Karam Prabhade, Potom Zarai, Pitamata, Mababa. I'm going to dormonize it, Potohan Guru, Pitamata. Even if your parents are non Muslim, Islam still says you have to be respectful. Elders, those who are above you, and some people are even 1 or 2 days older than us, Islam gives them that privilege. Remember I said you have to be kind to the younger, that's true, no doubt. But because someone older than you, he has the privilege of that respect, and he deserves the respect, and she deserves the respect, just because of the age. We don't have this anymore. Go to the Muslim world, and this is the reason why I believe every one of us should spend some time in the Muslim country. We have this. In our countries, people sometimes, in back home, sometimes people don't pray, but they have these things. When they see the elders, they stand up. So this is something that you cannot learn from the from books. You have to learn from practical tradition and culture. And this is the reason why it's important that we spend some time to teach our children and our younger generation about the Muslim culture. But there are a lot of good things within the culture, and they are derived and taken from religion. I know there are some cultures which are not in line with Islam, But there are cultures which are actually from Islam, like hospitality, feeding people, taking care of your guests. Where do the Muslims get this from? Why don't others do these things, same thing? Why Muslims do? Because it's from Islam. It's from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to understand the beauty of this religion. We can go on and on. And there are so many other points we can mention. Islam is a beautiful religion. No one should take it as, oh, it's like something that I have to do. It's not a burden. And I remember one of the scholars, new Muslim scholars from America, he said, when someone leaves Islam, he doesn't leave Islam, but Islam leaves him. He doesn't leave Islam, but Islam leaves him.
Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Malik Yawm al-Din. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ما كان على النبي من حرج فيما فرض الله له سنة الله في الذين خلوا من قبل وكان أمر الله قدرا مقدورا الذين يبلغون رسالات الله ويخشونه ولا يخشون أحدا إلا الله وكفى بالله حسيبا ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين وكان الله بكل شيء عليما يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا هو الذي يصلي عليكم وملائكته ليخرجكم من الظلمات إلى النور وكان بالمؤمنين رحيما تحيتهم يوم يلقونه سلام وأعد لهم أجرا كريما الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين يا أيها النبي أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا وَبَشِّرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ بِأَنَّ لَهُم مِّنَ اللَّهِ فَضْلًا كَبِيرًا وَلَا تُطِعِ الْكَافِرِينَ وَالْمُنَافِقِينَ وَدَعْ أَذَاهُمْ وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَكِيلًا. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.